You were calling Trump America's Hitler. Then you kissed his ass.
That's not true.
It is true. And then you kissed his ass, and then he endorsed you. And you said he's the greatest president of all time.
You were there to stand up for our Constitution. But when the barbarians were at the gate, you were happy to let them in.
I think I disagree with everything my opponent just said, including the words but and the.
A big debate night that was both contentious and personal. I'm John Berman with Brianna Keeler, and bad blood between Tim Ryan and J.D. Vance playing out on the debate stage last night in Ohio. You saw it there in the first clip. They were sparring over the economy and inflation, clashing over racist rhetoric and abortion. This race is more competitive than expected in a state that Donald Trump carried twice. Both men describing each other as ass kissers and suck ups. And that was the more friendly part of the debate.
Yeah, if you can believe that. Now in Utah, flashes of tension between the candidates, independent Evan McMullin attacking incumbent Republican Senator Mike Lee. They're accusing him of betraying America on January 6th. The debate was also a chance for McMullin to confront Lee over text messages that he sent to Mark Meadows, then President Trump's chief of staff, in the lead up to the attack on the Capitol. Lee denied doing anything wrong.
CNN's Omar Jimenez up all night watching these debates play out. Omar, what did you see?
Look, these were spirited, to say the least. Contentious for the second time in a row, at least in Ohio, the second time in as many debates between Tim Ryan and J.D. Vance. It felt personal at times. Well, meanwhile, in Utah, in that race, you've got the independent Evan McMullin against the incumbent Senator Mike Lee. And it's the only race where Democrats didn't field a candidate. And so the independent is fighting an uphill battle.
In two crucial Senate debates, party politics took center stage. In Ohio, Democrat Tim Ryan and Republican J.D. Vance debated for a second time in a closer-than-expected Senate race. An issue in one exchange, Donald Trump's endorsement of Vance.
The New York Times did a fake story today, big front page, that J.D. wasn't sure if he wanted my support. J.D. is kissing my ass. He wants my support.
I know the president very well, and absolutely, he was joking about a New York Times story. That's all he was doing. I didn't take offense to it.
If you can't even stand up for yourself, how are you going to stand up for the people of the state?
Vance, in return, hit Ryan repeatedly on his ties to House Speaker Nancy Pelosi.
The guy who's subservient to the national party is Tim Ryan, who's been begging for these guys to come into this race and save him from the campaign that he's been running.
You keep talking about Nancy Pelosi. If you want to run against Nancy Pelosi, move back to San Francisco and run against Nancy Pelosi. You're running against me.
The debate's most contentious moment was when discussing the so-called replacement theory, the idea that white people are being slowly and intentionally replaced by minorities and immigrants.
This is who he's running around with, talking about replacement theory. There's no big grand conspiracy. This is a country who's been enriched by immigrants from all quarters of the world. And there's no, in the problem,
it's shameful
the
for you
danger,
to accuse me of that, given my family,
the
Tim.
Danger.
It's shameful for you to accuse me
my
of that.
My turn, pal. My turn.
Oh, buddy.
My
your
turn.
All these guys, they just want to stoke this racial violence. We're tired of it, J.D.
What happens is that my own children, my biracial children, get attacked by scumbags online and in person because you are so desperate for political power that you'll accuse me, the father of three beautiful biracial babies, of engaging in racism. We are sick of it.
In Utah, incumbent Republican Senator Mike Lee and candidate Evan McMullin agree on most policies like inflation, the environment, and student loan cancellation. It's McMullin's campaign as an independent in a conservative state that's distinguishing the two.
I'm not going to Washington, if we prevail, to be a bootlicker for Donald Trump or Joe Biden.
To suggest that I'm beholden to either party, that I've been a bootlicker for either party, is folly, and it's contradicted by the plain facts.
It's unclear if McMullin can win as an independent in a state Trump carried in 2020. That election dividing the two candidates.
Yes, Joe Biden is our president. He was chosen in the only election that matters, the election held by the Electoral College.
Senator Lee,
You advised spurious so-called legal efforts to mislead tens of millions of Americans that the election had been stolen. And congratulations, you succeeded.
Text messages reported by CNN in April reveal that Lee did reach out to then White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows in the days after the election, initially supporting efforts to challenge the results.
You advised the White House find an alternative slate of electors for Trump to overturn the will of the people. That's what you said. When the barbarians were at the gate, you were happy to let them in.
Despite the evidence, Lee issued a stern denial.
There is absolutely nothing to the idea that I would have ever supported, ever did support, a fake electors plot.
If you can keep us divided, then that's how you hold on to power. You're used to that. But we're building a cross-partisan coalition to replace you, Senator Lee, and it must be done.
And in that race, Utah Senator Mitt Romney has declined to endorse either candidate, saying he's friends with both. But in doing so, is the only GOP senator who hasn't endorsed Lee, despite Lee pleading for him to do so. In Ohio, we've seen an infusion of national Republican money, which means that despite Tim Ryan vastly outraising J.D. Vance from July through September, Vance is set to outspend Ryan $11 to $3 million, at least on ads, from now through Election Day, which, by the way, is 3 weeks away.
One of the things that I think is important to see here is what they're each doing is trying to paint the other as extreme as possible. I mean, you know, Tim Ryan was just trying to like say J.D. Vance equals Marjorie Taylor Greene, right? Like that's his approach here, as they're both trying to court the vast middle of Ohio, which is how you would win an Ohio election. And of course, on the other side, you know, Vance does the same and tries to portray Ryan as completely left-wing extremism from his party. Part of what the dynamic that you're seeing here, you noted, or John noted at the top, this is a state Donald Trump won twice by 8 or 9 points.
I mean, it's a pretty red
place. It's
been
trending red, no doubt about that. It's a pretty red state. And there's such a spending disadvantage on the airwaves right now. I mean, since Labor Day, J.D. Vance and his outside group allies, I think, have been up on the air with $33 million worth of ads versus Tim Ryan and his outside group allies, $16 million since Labor Day. So Tim Ryan is not sort of getting the kind of investment from Democrats to even up the score here, at least on the airwaves, and that's why he's trying to make so much use of these debate moments.
J.D. Vance, to your point of he's trying to make him as left as he can make him, he's really trying to tie Tim Ryan to Nancy Pelosi. Here's that moment.
J.D., you keep talking about Nancy Pelosi. If you want to run against Nancy Pelosi, move back to San Francisco and run against Nancy Pelosi.
You vote with her 100% of the time, so you can't run from the policies that she has supported.
Tim Ryan's retort is to say you're not actually an Ohioan, or you sort of moved away or whatnot. You're right. Not a true Ohioan. How does that play?
Well, I think at this stage of the game, that kind of like carpetbagger argument probably is not the one at the end of the day that is going to win over these folks are in people's living rooms. They're engaged every day in this campaign. And so it's not like Ohioans are entirely discounting J.D. Vance's roots to the state. Obviously, you know, he wrote that book, Hillbilly Elegy. It's sort of how he came to fame here. But again, Ryan's mission here is to make Vance, right, as unacceptable as possible and trying to sort of remind people that he left Ohio behind for a huge swath of his career has been part of the narrative that he's been trying to build around him.
Fascinating race in Utah. Incumbent Senator Mike Lee, obviously going for re-election. He's being challenged by independent Evan McMullin, who does have the backing of a lot of Democrats. But he's trying to make this about January 6th. Mike Lee has been in text messages. We've seen these with Mark Meadows, the former chief of staff to then President Trump, talking about the fake elector scheme. And this is where you see a lot of this, the biggest debate moments they had, turning on. Here it is.
Yes, there were people who behaved very badly on that day. I was not one of them. I was one of the people trying to dismantle this situation, trying to stop it from happening, because I believe in this document written by the hands of wise men raised up by God to that very purpose. I followed it. I studied it. And I defended it to a T.
We'll have 30 seconds here in a moment.
For you to suggest otherwise looks right in the face of truth and in the face of the Constitution. How dare you, sir?
Mr. McMullin, you have 30 seconds.
Look, Senator Lee has been doing this thing with his pocket constitution for the last several years. Senator Lee, it is not a prop.
It is not a prop. If you're committed to the Constitution, then stand up for our free and fair election. Stand up for the peaceful transfer of power.
What are you watching in this race?
Well, it's amazing that we're talking about a Utah Senate race at all, right? And there's no Democratic candidate. The Democrats didn't field a candidate because McMullin, a former Republican, is running as an independent. And the Democrats sort of figured, well, that may be the best shot to dethrone Mike Lee from his seat. Have at it, Evan McMullin. I mean, here's the reality. These two guys agree on probably most public policy issues, but this January 6th issue is the dividing line. It is the rationale for McMullin's candidacy, a former CIA officer, as you know. And so this is what the campaign is about, is whether or not Mike Lee, when you notice through the text messages with Mark Meadows, through his actions to try and challenge the Electoral College results initially, all of that, is exactly what McMullin is citing as to why your argument that you're a constitutional conservative doesn't hold water. It is a very Republican state. Some polling out there limited, you know, has shown it closer than folks would expect. But I still think in this political environment, this is probably an uphill battle for McMullin.